much as you're crying, we need also to be honest with each other. We need to talk about how you are getting envelopes ndo mwende press conference. Tunajua guys, tunajua. Hizo basha mnapewa ndo mwende conferences. Hizo basha mnapewa ndo mlenge press conferences. We know. So stop that game. Stop that game. The politics of tribes. Let me tell you one thing, guys. And this is one thing that I'm going to be honest with before I end this junction. There is nothing that ignited the Rwanda genocide like the media. So the silence or the voice of the media is very important in the liberation of a country. And that is why whenever we are having a coup d'etat or whenever the government is having a change of tact, there is all the first person that is gone for is the media. If the media cannot be impartial, we do not have the resources as a people to go to the ground like the media. If the media cannot be impartial and all they can focus on is telling us how the Njurincheke feel about Mintika Linturi and his libido, then I am afraid, ladies and gentlemen, you are on your own. Serikali itawakon mbaka mukoniwe mbaka mshangae. Because you are in the bed with the government, you have been bed with the thieves. So wakati mnaibiwa mkubali, ukikuwa rafiki ya mwizi, jua siku moja akikosa pesa, wewe ndio atapiga ngeta. That is my junction for today. Venye cabinet imefutwa kazi, badala they focus on getting expatriates, kazi yao ni kutuambia, eti wa Kikuyu wamekasirika Moses Kuria amefutwa kazi. Ngombe sana.
If there is one thing in imenianoi sana all through this time ni hiyo, why for some reason wamekuwa so interested na kutuambia wale wamekuwa na shida. Kama leo nimeshinda nikiona sijui wanawake wanasema sijui tuachane na nani asiingiliwe, sijui nani na yeye anasema wakisi. It's just so annoying because nobody even asked for you to give us the impressions of particular groups and sections of people. It's very annoying.
I think that also Kenyans will need to stop pretending. We love news, bwana. Tunapenda news, tunapenda vile wamekuwa kitu peke yake, kitu maybe it's changing, our policy is changing, but think about it. Right now, ukiweka hapa topic, Raila ameshikwa akiiba kura za AU. Ukiweka tu topic kama hiyo, hapa kutaja chrome kutakuwa na 1K people. Kitu kingine wa Kenya wanapenda ni udaku. Nguo za soy pants zimepatikana ziko kwa gari ya Jemo. Again, 100 million people wataja hapa. So tuwache kujifanya, tuwache kujifanya. We like the way they've been treating us and the way they've been giving us this news. We like politics and we like, so let's not pretend. Let's say maybe our palate is changing or we need to change some things, but we have to be factual also. So we have to have critical media. We also have to be factual in terms of what it means to produce ego-jichopevu type of things. It's more news, more critical thinking, more analysis, more interviews, more nini, more time kwa grao, unaona? Na kusema kweli, I'm not excusing them, but I'm also trying to be balanced here in the way we think about the media. The media is biased, of course we know that. But at the same time, we have to think about the production of what Moha was doing, for example, like Jitopevu. That is a whole month of an investigation of something, of X, or an investigation of the killings of Kware, for example. That will take a long time. I'm not saying that they cannot do it. They can and they have the resources. They're just choosing not to do it because they're biased. But also, we have to be okay and be aware of who we are as Kenyans, that tunapenda politics. So let's begin that. Adeyoni, my feedback to you, people.
To a large extent, I agree with you fully that the media is becoming biased, the media is fueling propaganda, and the media is a serious contributor to tribalism. Because I also wonder, today there was a fight in a church in Kisii, was it today or yesterday? And the media have gone there. The videos which were captured by mobile phones, I've seen them on Citizen TV verified or Twitter handle. I mean, well, such events, such scenarios, I mean, which cannot be verified. I don't know if Citizen TV verified that before they put it or they uploaded it on their verified handle, in a way, doesn't sit well with the people. Number two, the way in which the media have covered, they were treated initially when we started the war with the government, when we started the revolution, they were very good. They were covering us, and they were able to highlight to the world that something is wrong in Kenya. They are able to speak out clearly, and everybody else would understand that something is wrong in Kenya. We were doing the keyboard warriors on Twitter, and we were on the ground. X, we were fueling everything on X. But then the president came out and said, look, you have to do this. And they have curtailed. Wamekunja mikia, wameweka mikia katikati ya miguu. Information from them, and they do not want to be brought to account. The moment they are brought to account, or they are asked to be accountable, they run on the streets and say, "We are under attack. Democracy under attack." Democracy is not just the media alone. Democracy is also for me and you. The moment you are fueling, you are going to my village, to Homa Bay in my village, to cover. I mean, plastic process tests. I say plastic celebrations because those people are paid. I was not at, I'm not in the village. I'm in Nairobi, but I've been told the people are paid because Mbadi knew that he was going to be appointed. In fact, if you saw 2-3 days ago, when he was somewhere, he was speaking, it was Orengo had tried to make some comments to suggest that ODM should not go into government. But he came out to oppose him strongly. He knew these things, that he was going to be appointed. So he arranged everything. He called the media, gave them a check, and said, look, there's going to be a celebration here. Media, in a way, are also biased. There was a time, I'm just finishing up, there was a time we wanted a story to be covered by NTV. Or by, let me not mention the media house exactly, but a certain media house. What happened? They asked us for one of the journalists said, can we have something from you? Can we have a check from you? I was working with USAID by then, before I went out of the country, and then now I'm now back in the country, always out and back. I was working with USAID. It was about a school girl who had been raped. For this story to be covered, because the person, the perpetrator, was a big fish, the media asked for something in such a very sensitive matter. We had to part with 10,000 Kenya shillings. So I agree with you, and I agree with everybody here, that the media should be called out for whatever they are. And at the same time, we also help them to propagate the propaganda. We help them to do the dirty deals they do. And on that, hii kwanza wametuangusha sasa juzi sana kabisa. Wametuangusha kabisa. Wanaweka Citizen TV, wanaweka mseto. Na bunduki na lia. Shame. Risasi ina lia Zimmerman. Watu wana finyo kule makende. Mimi mwenye kukubaza. Watu wana finyo makende gizurai. Na wao wanaweka ati mseto. Ati double platinums. Ati mbosho. Shame. A big shame on them. Eh? Ati watu wanaweka yoga. Ati yoga na Fredo bachi machoka. Shame. Na nimeenda.
But why would you do that and still in the evening come and say kulikuwa na maandamano maeneo ya Kisii?
Now while you would like to look at the media and think that it's free, we ourselves are not free, to be honest. There are things that we should look at fundamentally. We should all look to bring up our own media. that will cover us at our own designated times, that we can rely on. It is very definite that the government switched off the media in our last day of Maandamano, even when the media themselves were demonstrating. The media was switched off. The televisions could not show what was going on the ground. And mind you, they were on the ground trying to cover up, but the general people work for things that support us, support our cause. I think we need to look at people who can do it. We support them wholly. We keep them moving. Everybody will be important wherever he is, whether you're tweeting. I keep on saying this, that everybody is important wherever he is. Whatever you're doing, whether it's tweeting, whether it's going to the field, I mean, on the real demonstrations, or when coming up with the placards, I believe that if this cause has to remain strong, everybody has to keep going, doing whatever you're doing effectively. So the media is not really, I mean, free. Neither us. We can't say whatever we want to say the way we want to say it, because someone can pop in, come for you in the evening. Let's try to work on bringing up a stronger media that is within us. That's my submission for today.
Our media let us down. Because imagine connection happened because they have been threatened, only threatened. Your day hakuna kitu alikavara, unaona? So mi kitu ulikuwa nataka kusema ni kila mtu yoyote akona hiyo opportunity, let us be our own media. Anything na happen, try to air it out. Ukiwa mahali, try to educate people, bring it on the media. Will hata ukileta hapa Twitter, tutaretweet. Okay, and then the next thing, nataka kuambia watu, tusichoke. Me, I think for the last 3 days, nilikuwa almost to give up. Lakini, vile nimeona vitu zinaendelea, nimeendelea kupata moyo ili kupigania watu. So, thank you so much.
Ukiangalia on the world's most famous dictators, their first step ya dictatorship ilikuwa gani? Ilikuwa kudeprive watu from something we call information. So that's the first way you go in a dictatorship. You suppress information ya watu hawakuwa informed, mtu ajui nini ina happen. So by that, people get into something we call total darkness. So ukifanya hivyo, what you feed them is what they will believe. Kwa sababu gani kenye unawaambia ndio inakuwa ni kama first hand information to them. And we all know kitu ukipata, it's always very hard to alter a first impression. Ikuwe either ni wrong, ikuwe ilikuwa rumors, ikuwe ni right, but it is always hard to alter a first impression. And that is why this guy anajua, he knows the best way to infiltrate ni kunyonga media. Ndiyo so, Kenya media itakuwa inatuambia, ndiyo tutakuwa tunabelieve from him. Wale watu wenye wako pale mashinani, most of them hawana network, hawana data, hawana nini, so they rely on TVs. Ile uongo wenye anawaambia pale na zile vitu zenye wanapost pale, ndizo watu watabelieve. There is somebody who said we should embark on our vernacular channels. I support that. Kwa sababu gani? Pale Rulo, watu wanaonaga those vernacular channels. So if we can do, tuende pale, we occupy there, and at least push them to do what is right. It will be easier for us to do civic education Lakini tukikubali kugo about venye huyu mzee ametuweka, we'll have a problem. Kwa sababu tutakuwa tunatokea, kirudi jioni, unapata some other kind of information kutoka mzazi kwa kenye ameona. I was so bitter on Tuesday. The mainstream media hawakupost anything kuhusu protests. Alafu waka protest on Wednesday. Was there as not a protest? Nielezewe, juu ni kama nimepotea kidogo. Ama yetu ilikuwa protest yao ilikuwa kitu ingine. Anyway, so we should embark on that. We have TikToks, tuko na nini. At least let us come up with mainstream to a challenge na zina vitu zenye tuko nazo. Na with that, watakuwa na ile tutawa guilt trip. And I am sure we Kenyans, kitu ikipostiwa, it is very easier for somebody to go in the comments than what? Than to read the whole thing. Tuangalia hiyo sana, tusikubali kuwa colonized through lack of information. Pia sisi tuna make attempt, we ukipata kitu, ambia mwenzako. Tusikuwe kwa giza. Thank you very much.
So thank you once again for the opportunity. For me, I think that media, hope I can be heard. Nanesikia?
Yeah, you can be heard. Uko loud.
So I think media is not free, and I'll give them some point. I think mostly some of the media guys who are on the ground, because their camera is always rolling, they get the truth, but once the details are submitted into their media center, I think it's usually audited by some guys, maybe someone who works there can tell us. Then that's the problem. That's where the narrative is controlled. Because, of course, kuna camera kwa street, camera imeonyesha staff ikifanyika. Ikifika huko, you know, the bureaucracy, lazima ipitie through, you know, auditors, and that's where we lose it. That's where the narrative are usually controlled. Of course, people really prefer the truth to be, you know, generally we consider the media our vision, the our side, because unajua mimi siwezi kuwa Tarakaniti na nikuwe CIA at the same time. So whatever they are telling us, that's what most of us perceive as truth, but unfortunately most of it is always edited. So another important thing about media is, you know, actually PP, since I started listening to Space, I've really learned a lot. Hata ni kama inafaa nipewe degree sasa ya mambo zingine ya information juu sasa Space, as in nimekuwa nikiona TV zo miaka zote na hakuna kitu unashika hapa. Tafadhali Space bana, you get some key points. There's a lot of good information out there. Hata sasa inaweza sema article kadhaa ya constitution, my friend. Si mchezo. So I think we should take that to our advantage and try as much as possible to get the information out there, the real information narrative out there. For instance, ile bako ya cost watu kulipwa, uliona coverage yote ya media ya those big medias? No. So actually my information I usually go to, I trust my community in the X and my community in TikTok. They produce the raw authentic info than the big media houses. So it's of course another thing is you know, if media were to be accountable, and if media would really want to play a big role in and impact the community. So you realize that, for instance, wale makara walikuwa wamevaa mask, whatever, So the media can expose them. I know they have the resources. Sisi tunaweza ona to post, to jaribu. Even people are trying to expose these guys on TikTok and space and giving. But media can't do that because wako scared. I believe maybe they are scared. Or even bootlicking the politician and where the earn is coming from is where they tend to promote their narrative. I think that's about it. Thank you.